Okay, so you've gotten your titles and graphics just the way you want. You thought about your audience and the response you want from it. You've even given careful consideration to good typographical design, and perhaps you've even bent or broken the rules just a little bit. But hey, at least you know why you did it. So you're finished, right? Well, it depends. You could just let your work just lie there, lifeless and still, but being the creative genius that you are, you probably want to bring your creation to life. We're going to show you how. It's all using a technique called keyframing. With it, you can give your titles energy and professionalism. Keyframing is the process of smoothly transitioning one set of values for a particular property to a different set of values. Okay, for example, in the editing software, let's place an object in the upper left corner of the screen. Then, 29 frames later, we'll place it in the lower right corner. When we play it through, we will see the object just sitting in the upper left corner for 29 frames, then jumping to the lower right corner in the last frame. So, how do we get a smooth transition between the two corners? Well, we could calculate a straight line between the two positions divided by 30, determine the XY coordinates for each of the 30 points along the line, and then for each new frame, place a copy of the object. But that's an awful lot of work. Instead, we can just let keyframing take the mathematics out of our hands. Place one keyframe at the starting point and another at the ending point, and the computer will handle the rest of the calculations for us. The result? A smooth transition in a fraction of the time it would have taken by hand. Now let's look a little further and see how keyframes can be applied to various properties of motion, opacity, and more. Opacity is a property that sees a lot of keyframing action. It's often used in the opening titles of films to fade in logos and text. However, there are a lot of interesting ways of using them. We're going to be using opacity keyframes to make a glitchy title for a utility company. To fade your title in and out of view, place it on the timeline and position it to the location you want. Move the time indicator to the point on the timeline where you want the title to be fully visible and set the opacity keyframe. In our case, it will be at the beginning of the timeline. Now move three frames forward in the clip and change the opacity value to 0%. A new keyframe appears and the title vanishes. Advance two more frames forward and set the opacity value back to 100%. Play the clip and watch the title quickly fade in and out of view. At this point, you'll want to randomly copy and paste these keyframes to the rest of your title until you're satisfied with the result. Here's what our keyframes and animation ended up looking like. For a crosses all between two clips, overlap them on the timeline by placing one clip on the video track and another clip on the video track directly above it. Then shift the clip on the left just by 1 second. This is how long our dissolve will last. Select the bottom title and at the point where the top title begins, set a 100% opacity keyframe. Advance 1 second in the timeline and change the opacity of the bottom title to 0%. Without moving the time indicator, select the top title and set a 100% opacity keyframe. This way, it'll be fully visible after the bottom title fades away. Now go to the first frame of the upper title and change its opacity value to 0%. Play through the timeline and you'll see the first fade out as the second fades in for a very nice cross dissolve. Changing an object's position is the most used keyframe effect by far. Rather than having your title simply fade on screen, you may prefer to have it slide in from the side. Movie titles like the ones in Catch Me If You Can use position keyframes to not only animate characters on the screen, but to give motion to the titles as well. It's often better to begin by setting a keyframe for the property's final set of values. Place the current time indicator on the timeline at the point where you want the title to stop. Next, place your title in the center of the preview window by clicking and dragging it into position, and then scrubbing the position values to get it just right. Click the stopwatch icon or toggle animation button next to the position property. A keyframe indicator will appear on the right on the effects timeline. Next, place the current time indicator at the point on the timeline where you want the motion to begin. Scrub the horizontal value of the position property until the title disappears off the left side of the screen. Notice that a new keyframe appears automatically on the effects timeline. Now you have a nice smooth transition as your title slides in from the left and takes its place in the center of the screen. Rotation is often used to grab the audience's attention by having the title or graphic tumble or spin on or off the screen. To rotate text on screen, put the current time indicator on the timeline at the point where you want the rotation to end. Click on the value for rotation and enter 0. Now move the current time indicator to where you want the rotation to begin and enter the number of degrees you want the object to rotate. A new keyframe appears and your title will now rotate smoothly into place. So now you can also combine rotation and position keyframes to create a tumble effect. Simply set a rotation keyframe at the same time the object's horizontal motion begins and end them together. When played through, your title will tumble into place from off screen. Changes to an object scale can be used to zoom into a particular feature or word on the screen. When combined with the position keyframing, this is known as pan and scan, or the Ken Burns effect. It may also be used to direct the viewer's eye to a certain portion on the screen. For example, using position keyframes, slide your logo onto the center screen from the left. Move the current time indicator to the position where you want the change to begin. Click the Add Remove Keyframe button to set a keyframe for position and scale. This establishes the current position and the scale at 100%. Without this step, there will be no pause. Your logo will slide in and immediately begin to scale down while it's moving into its position. Now, move the time indicator to the place where you want the animation to end. Enter 30% as the new scale value and drag the logo to the lower right corner. Play it through, and you've just created a very simple bug. You put in a lot of hard work to get your titles and graphics just right. Bring them to life by using these keyframing techniques, and you'll fully engage your viewers for optimal impact and successful results.